I'm Tammy Colda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. On this YouTube channel, I am covering the contents of my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, a concise guide to TikZ and PGF plots, linked in the show notes. I'll also cover some bonus material. If you like this channel, please subscribe, post questions, and share with your friends and colleagues. Today's topic is naming coordinates. So this means I'll cover two different ways to name your coordinates, naming a coordinate along a path segment, and pulling the x value from one coordinate and the y value from another. I'm assuming you're already a little bit familiar with TikZ. If not, please go back and watch my previous videos. As usual, we'll create our graphics today using overleaf.com. So we'll start with a new project, blank project. I'll go ahead and call this one Naming Coordinates and TikZ LaTeX Graphics. And then I'll go ahead and paste a little bit of stuff at the top to get us ready. So I'm gonna get rid of the graphic x package. And I'm going to use TikZ, which is the most important package. And I'll use a few other things to make things nice. Bar skip and full page just make the formatting nice and hyperref so that I can link you back to this video series. The first thing we can do is name a coordinate explicitly in a standalone line. Let me give you an example. I'll paste some code here and we'll go ahead and compile it. The name of a coordinate can be any combination of letters, numbers, and spaces. Here I've named the coordinate alpha. And so the format, when I do it in its own line, is coordinate alpha at 1, 1. Defining a coordinate doesn't actually do anything other than create it so that you can see where it is. I went ahead and put a red circle at that point alpha. And you can see that it is indeed at the coordinate 1, 1 because I've drawn a help grid. Now we can use that coordinate over and over again. So here I'll use it in drawing a triangle and we'll go ahead and compile that. And so I have a triangle that starts at 1, 1. It goes up 40 degrees, a distance of 3, using polar coordinates here. And then we've made that relative with the plus plus. And then the third coordinate is also relative, going down 40 degrees, and again, a length of 3. And then we cycle back to close out the triangle. I've covered relative coordinates and polar coordinates in previous videos, which are linked in the show notes. Now, defining coordinates this way can be a bit pedantic. We can just name them right in line along with our path. So here's another example. I am naming the coordinate right in the path. So the 1, 1 coordinate, I just follow that with coordinate alpha. So compare that to the way I did it explicitly, where I called out coordinate alpha at 1, 1. Here I have the 1, 1, and that's then just coordinate alpha. Now the next point in my triangle is a relative point that's 40 degrees of distance of 3 away from the first point. I don't actually know its explicit coordinates. I haven't calculated them, but I can still name that and reuse that coordinate. So I call that beta. And likewise, the last relative coordinate, I'll go ahead and name that and call it gamma. Just so you can see where these coordinates are, I've put three circles on them. So I put a red circle at alpha, a cyan circle at beta, and a purple circle at gamma. Another interesting way we can name coordinates with TikZ is to name a coordinate partway along a path segment. So what do I mean by that? Let me show you some example code. So here I'll compile a little bit of code that draws yet another triangle. So we name the 1, 1 coordinate alpha as before, and now we're doing a funny thing, which is following the dash dash between the second and third coordinate. I add coordinate with an optional argument position equals 0.5 and then the name of delta. And so this just says that I am putting that coordinate along this path. And just to so that you can see these two coordinates, I went ahead and colored them in. Remember that the slash draw is shorthand for slash path with the draw option. In fact, we need not draw a path at all to place a coordinate. Extending this example, we're going to take another path, which we're doing between alpha and delta, and I place two coordinates this time. I place a coordinate epsilon at position 0.5 along that path, and a coordinate zeta at position 0.7 along that path. Just so you can see that I colored epsilon as teal and zeta as magenta. There's a little bit of flexibility in exactly where these coordinate declarations go. Here I put it after the delta. In general, I'd actually recommend that you put it immediately following the dash dash, and then that will work just the same as before. Name coordinates have a multitude of uses that we'll get to as this series of videos progresses. One use is that you can take the x coordinate from one named coordinate and the y coordinate from another named coordinate. The symbol is bar dash or dash bar, depending on whether you want the x value from the first, which is bar dash, or second coordinate, which is dash bar. Let me give you an example that'll hopefully make this clear. Let me compile this. The first thing I've done is draw a triangle as before, and I've named the coordinates alpha, beta, and gamma. So first we draw a red line from alpha to the x coordinate of alpha and the y coordinate of beta. So we have the bar dash notation here. So we start at alpha and then we go to the x coordinate of alpha and the y coordinate of beta. So that's that line. Second, we do the same thing, drawing a teal line from gamma to the point that has the same x coordinate as gamma and the same y coordinate as beta. Lastly, we draw an arrow from this point alpha bar dash beta to the point that is beta dash bar gamma. So in this case, we've taken, instead of the x coordinate first, we've taken the y coordinate first because we use the dash bar notation, and then we take the x coordinate from gamma. There's a link in the Overleaf document we created today in the show notes. Please click like or subscribe if you want more videos like this. Thanks for watching.